Hey guys, it's Shio from the Nintendo Kari Bros, and today we are doing a rumor roundup of Apple's Worldwide Developers Conference. So, let's get started. Okay guys, we're going to be starting off with iOS. Now, it is rumored that in iOS 10, it is expected that we are going to be including a redesigned Apple Music app with a more intuitive user interface and a bolder, more streamlined design. The new tab is set to be replaced with a browse option, and better access to song lyrics will be included, making Apple Music easier than ever to use. Now, I know, I've been using Apple Music, I love it, and I just feel like they need to polish it a little bit more, because right now, it's alright, you know, not the best, but, you know, needs a little improvement. It just came out too, so. Anyways, we are also expected to see Siri becoming even more smarter and more intuitive and handling more intuitive questions. We can see this with Google Now in the Google I.O. conference. They are pretty much having a conversation with the API, and it was, you know, like a normal conversation. So after you ask something like, hey, what's the weather today? And she'll tell you and then say, so how much is it in like another city or another state or another community? You see what I'm saying? So it's going to be almost like that. Mac rumor says that it's going to be like that. So yeah, and finally we might be seeing Apple Pay support for web browsers, allowing Apple Pay to be used to make purchases via Safari. Now we do have apps that can pay in Apple Pay, and we also have in-store, like, touch, you know. So, I mean, this will just add more support, more, like, easier interface, so you don't really have to download anything, and, you know, you'll be able to use that feature and use the same, like, speedy process. Next, we are going to be seeing improvements to the Photos app, but we don't yet know what features will be added to that Photos app. So yeah, hopefully that they'll add more customization when you're taking videos, when you're, you know, doing all sorts of things like that. Next is OS X. One of the rumored features that will be included in OS X may possibly be Siri integration. Yes, I just said it, Siri integration. Now, hold up. We know that Cortana is on Windows, so, you know, it's nothing new, but it just, I feel like Siri should have gone onto the Macs a long time ago, and hopefully they'll put it in and have it released in this new OS X event. So, as we can see in this picture, the colorful Siri button will be available in the menu bar and through an icon on the dock. So, Siri on the Mac will presumably be able to perform all the same functions that iOS's Siri has, such as opening apps, playing music, and answering queries. Along with Siri integration, OS X may include an updated version of iTunes. Yes, I know, iTunes is such, it just needs to be cleaned up, because right now it's just a mess, and you know, they just need to make it much more cleaner, and you know, and this updated version of iTunes is said to be included with the redesigned Apple Music experience to match changes coming in iOS 10, and may support unlocking Macs. This is another feature, by the way. This is said, it says that you may be able to unlock your Mac via an iPhone and Apple Pay in the browser. Finally, we are also expected to see, of course, some improvements in the Photos app. Next are the Macs that we are possibly seeing. Now, we could possibly see refreshes to some of the Mac models, including the Retina MacBook Pro, the Mac Mini, and the Mac Pro, now, which are overdue for an update. I feel like they should get an update, because it's just time that Apple, you know, just adds a little things. But we've heard that the new MacBook Pro is said to have an OLED strip. Yes, an OLED strip on the MacBook Pro's keyboard. So this is going to be taking up the function keys, where we see, you know, of course, the function keys, and also the volume up, volume down, play, pause button. So we've already seen this type of integration in, let's say, for example, the Razer Blades with their Switch interface, Switchblade user interface, and it, you know, just makes it a lot more easier. The cool thing about this is if you change applications, the bar will automatically be customized to whatever the developer wanted it to be. So it's pretty cool. And we are also expected to see a new Thunderbolt display, which is set to have its own GPU inside, so it won't be taking up the power that your let's say your MacBook Pro is using with this GPU. So it'll have a better GPU and a much more powerful one. So yeah. Now you might be asking, what about the watchOS and the tvOS? Well, those we don't know too much about. So one can assume maybe little bug fixes, you know, little improvements. You know, we never know. That's pretty much it for my rumor video, guys. Hope you guys liked it. I am going to probably be doing an event coverage, so stay tuned for that. And yeah, thanks for watching, guys. I'll see you later. Peace.